सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल एंड प्रेस बेल आइकन टू गेट ऑल नोटिफिकेशन.
Now we will start with the hello phyta. With classifier, so the characteristics used for the classification of plant kingdom. Now let's see what are the characteristics of all the division of the kingdom plantae. We'll start with the hello phyta. हम hello phyta से start कर रहे हैं. The characteristics of the hello phyta that we already discussed that the plant body is not differentiated. The plants which do not have differentiated plant body, they are kept into the group that is the hello phyta. हमने देखा था कि जिन प्लांट्स के अंदर डिफरेंशिएटेड प्लांट बॉडी नहीं थी उसे हमने थैलोफाइटा किंगडम ग्रुप में रखा था. सो दीज प्लांट्स डू नॉट हैव डिफरेंशिएटेड प्लांट बॉडी मींस वी आर नॉट एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई द रूट्स स्टेम लीव्स फ्लावर एक्सेट्रा. सब कुछ जो होता है एक इस तरीके से ऑर्गेनाइज होगा कि हम आइडेंटिफाई नहीं कर सकते विच पार्ट ऑफ द प्लांट इज अ रूट विच पार्ट ऑफ द प्लांट इज अ स्टेम. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक. सेकेंड थिंग इज दैट दे आर प्रीडोमिनेंटली एक्वेटिक. These type of plant are predominantly aquatic. ये aquatic होते हैं means they live into the water. They live inside the water or on the surface of the water. Water can be marine or the fresh water. तो ये पानी में ही रहेंगे aquatic होंगे and they are known as algae. Such type of the plants which we include into the thallophyta group, they are known as algae. Especially जो इनके लिए name use होता है that is the algae. And these algae are we can say these are the क्लोरोफिल बियरिंग. इनके अंदर क्लोरोफिल प्रेजेंट होता है एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस क्लोरोफिल दे आर एबल टू प्रोड्यूस देयर फूड. ये अपना फूड खुद प्रिपेयर कर सकते हैं. सो दे आर टोटली दे आर ऑटोट्रॉफ. तो ये ऑटोट्रॉफ होंगे बिकॉज दे हैव क्लोरोफिल एंड ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ क्लोरोफिल दे आर एबल टू प्रोड्यूस देयर फूड. दे आर एबल टू डू फोटोसिंथेसिस एंड दीज आर द सम एग्जांपल ऑफ थैलोफाइट्स. Examples of thallophytes are Zoolothrix, Spirogyra, Cladophora, Chara, etc. We can include these examples. Like here, the diagram of the Zoolothrix is shown. In the Zoolothrix, we can say that it is a plant body which is not differentiated. यहाँ पे हम ये identify नहीं कर सकते कि कौन सा plant का part जो है वो root की तरह काम कर रहा है और कौन सा plant part जो है वो एक stem की तरह या leaf की तरह काम कर रहा है. Similarly, अगर हम Spirogyra की structure देखते हैं, Spirogyra which you have studied earlier, आपने अपनी पिछली क्लासेस में भी स्पायरोगायरा का पढ़ा हुआ है. स्पायरोगायरा इज जस्ट अ रिबन लाइक शेप. स्पायरोगायरा की जो शेप होती है दैट इज अ रिबन लाइक शेप. तो रिबन लाइक स्ट्रक्चर इसके अंदर प्रेजेंट रहती है एंड इन दिस रिबन लाइक शेप वी कैन से दैट इट्स नॉट लुक लाइक अ प्लांट. हमने बोल सकते कि ये प्लांट की तरह नजर आता है. क्या ये कहीं से लगता है आपको कि प्लांट की तरह नजर आ रहा है? नो, इट्स नॉट लुक्स लाइक अ प्लांट बिकॉज प्लांट बॉडी इज नॉट डिफरेंशिएटेड. इट्स लुक्स लाइक अ रिबन. Long ribbon-like structure is there. This is Spirogyra and this is the Zoolothrix. So in the thallophyta, we can say that plant body is not differentiated. They are aquatic, predominantly aquatic. Predominantly मतलब कि most of these member of this group live into the water. So these are predominantly aquatic and they are called as algae. They are called as algae and they contain chlorophyll by which they are able to produce their food. So they are phototrophs. And the example of thallophyta are Zoolothrix, Spirogyra, Cladophora and one more is there, that is Chara. We can include these. So this is about the thallophyta. After that we will discuss next group, that is Bryophyta. Next group is Bryophyta. Let's see what are the characteristics of the group Bryophyta or division Bryophyta. Bryophytes have the differentiated plant body. As we have already discussed that the plants which do not have differentiated plant body, they are kept into the group that is thallophyta. We have thallophyta mein rakh diya. Now all the plant which we are just going to discuss, they all have differentiated plant body. In sabke andar differentiated plant body present hogi. So we can say that they have differentiated plant body. इनके अंदर प्लांट बॉडी जो होती है वो डिफरेंशिएटेड होती है. वी कैन आइडेंटिफाई द स्टेम लीफ एटसेट्रा. सेकंड इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट द प्लांट मेंबर्स ऑफ दिस ग्रुप ऑफ दिस डिविजंस आर नॉन एज एम्फीबियंस ऑफ द प्लांट किंगडम. इनके लिए एक स्पेशल वर्ड यूज किया गया दैट इज दैट एम्फीबियंस ऑफ द प्लांट किंगडम. वी कॉल देम एम्फीबियंस ऑफ प्लांट किंगडम. रीजन इज दैट दे आर द प्लांट्स विच स्टार्टिंग लिविंग ऑन the earth, on the land. Like in the thallophyta, we said that they are aquatic plants. Thallophytes are aquatic plants. So these are the plants which starting living or surviving onto the land. But these plants are required water for their reproduction. Means क्या है इन plants के अंदर ये land पे survive तो कर सकते हैं. They survive onto the land, but for their reproduction process, they form their gametes and these gametes need to water to fuse with each other. एक दूसरे के साथ fuse करने के लिए यानी कि reproduction करने के लिए they require water. So for this they can survive onto the land as well as they can survive into the water also. Or we can say they depends on the water also. That's why they are known as amphibians of the plant kingdom. This is the special name. इस पे बहुत important questions पूछे जाते हैं. The teacher can directly ask to you which group of the plant kingdom is known as amphibian of the plant kingdom, or why the bryophytes are known as amphibians of the plant kingdom. So you have to keep it remember that they are bryophytes are known as amphibians of the plant kingdom because they live onto the land, but for their reproduction, for their gamete fusion, they require water also. Next important characteristic, they have vascular tissues. They do not have vascular tissues. Means vascular tissues are absent here. Here we included one more characteristic. हमने यहाँ पे अब next characteristics include कर दिए. That is about vascular tissue. So they do not bear any vascular tissues. Means xylem and phloem. They are not present inside these plants. So they do not have any vascular tissues. Example of such kind of plants are mosses, Marchantia, and Brassia. That are the some example of the bryophytes in which we can say that the vascular tissues are absent and differentiated plant body in which stems, leaves and other parts of the plants can be easily seen. So these are about the characteristics about the bryophyte. Next we will discuss about the next group, that is pteridophytes. So we will start with the pteridophyta. Now let's discuss the characteristics of next group, that is pteridophyta. Pteridophyta, these are the plants which have differentiated plant body. In the thallophyta, the plants do not have differentiated plant body. When we move on to the next group, that is bryophyta, they have differentiated plant body, but they do not contain any specialized vascular tissues. इतना हम कर चुके हैं. अब हम देखेंगे pteridophyta में क्या characteristics हमें मिल रही हैं. In the pteridophyta, they have differentiated plant body. ठीक है, ये हो गया हमारा first characteristics. अगर अब हम बात करते हैं नेक्स्ट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक की, दैट इज वास्कुलर टिश्यूज. सो दिस इज द ग्रुप व्हिच आर द लैंड प्लांट्स व्हिच कंटेन अ वेरी डेवलप्ड वास्कुलर टिश्यू. दे आर द फर्स्ट प्लांट, दे सर्वाइव ऑनटू द लैंड कंप्लीटली. दे सर्वाइव ऑनटू द लैंड एंड दे हैव स्पेशलाइज्ड वास्कुलर टिश्यू. इनके अंदर वास्कुलर टिश्यूज प्रेजेंट होते हैं. मींस दे कंटेन जाइलम एंड दे कंटेन फ्लोएम. Xylem helps in the transportation of water and phloem helps in the transportation of food. So both of these two vascular tissues are present in the bryophytes. Pteridophytes. In the pteridophytes. Next, the example of these pteridophytes are Marsilia and ferns. We include Marsilia, ferns, and host tails into this group of pteridophytes. So in the pteridophyte, we have discussed that plants have a differentiated plant body. We can identify the stem, leaf, and other part of the plant. Second, they contain well-developed vascular tissues for the transportation of the substances into the plant body. And the example of these plants are Marsilia and the fern and host tail, etc. So here we discussed the three groups: thallophytes, bryophytes, and pteridophytes. All these three groups in तीनों group के अंदर एक special चीज है. The important thing about these three groups are that in these three groups the reproductive organs are found in the hidden form. यानी कि इनके जो रिप्रोडक्टिव ऑर्गन होते हैं, जो पार्ट रिप्रोडक्शन में हेल्प करते हैं, दे जस्ट फॉर्म स्पोर्स. ये स्पोर्स बनाएंगे, मींस देयर एम्ब्रियोस आर द नेक्ड एम्ब्रियो. इनके एम्ब्रियो नेक्ड एम्ब्रियो होते हैं. दे आर नॉट प्रेजेंट इनसाइड एनी फ्रूट और इनसाइड एनी सीड. दे हैव नेक्ड एम्ब्रियो व्हिच आर नोन एज व्हिच मींस व्हिच आर यूज्ड फॉर द रिप्रोडक्शन. And the reproductive organs of these three groups, thallophyta, bryophyta, and pteridophyta. The reproductive organ of these three groups are hidden reproductive organ. That's why they have given a one important name, that is cryptogames. They are known as cryptogames. Cryptogames and the another group which we are going to discuss later, that is gymnosperm and angiosperm. They have well developed reproductive organ and which are hidden inside the fruit. or seed ke andar, we can that embryo is present inside the seed. And such kind of the fruit seed bearing plants are known as phanerogames. So here we can classify the plants into the two groups also on the basis of their reproductive organ, like phanerogames and cryptogames. In the cryptogames, we include the thallophyta, bralphyta and dendrophyta. Whereas into the phanerogames, which are the seed producing plants, we include the gymnosperms and angiosperm. So now let's take a look on the difference between the cryptogames and phanerogames. After that, we will discuss about the angiosperm and gymnosperm. Now let's see the differences between cryptogames and phanerogames. The cryptogames, as we have already told, crypto means hidden. So we can say that these are the plants which have hidden reproductive organ. So first difference is they reproduce by forming the spores. These cryptogames, they do not form any specialized structure in which the reproductive organs or the reproduction is done by any specialized means like seed, etc. They just form spores by which they do their reproduction. So we can say that they reproduce by forming spores. They form a spore which directly gets germinate and they will form a new plant. So spores are formed here. In these phanerogames, they reproduce by forming seeds. They form seeds. They are seed forming plants. Second thing that about their reproductive organ, crypto, hidden. So they have hidden reproductive organ, whereas phanerogames have a very exposed reproductive organ. We can easily see their reproductive organs. Like we can see the seed, we can see the fruit in which the seed is present. So they have exposed reproductive organs. These type of plants like cryptogames, they are less evolved plants. Means we are not saying that they are very highly developed. They are less evolved. Like we discussed about the thallophyta, bralphyta, pteridophyta. In the thallophyta, the plant body is not differentiated. Whereas in the bralphyta, the vascular tissues are not found. So such type of the plants are not well evolved. So we can say that they are less evolved plants. But the phanerogames, in which we include the gymnosperms and angiosperms, they are highly evolved plants. They have vascular tissue, they reproduce by forming seeds, and they have transportation system by the vascular tissues, and they have differentiated plant body. Sub characteristics jo ek normally plant ke andar develop plant ke andar present hoti hai, they have all these characteristics. So we can say that they are highly evolved plants. In this group, that is the cryptogames, we include thallophyta, bryophyta and pteridophyta. These three groups are included into the cryptogames, whereas in the phanerogames we include the only gymnosperms and angiosperms, which are the developed plants or highly developed plants. Gymnosperm and angiosperms are included into the phanerogames. If we talk about the examples, into the cryptogames we can include the mosses, the fern, etc. But in the case of phanerogames, we can include the developed plants like mango can be included here, pine, cycas. These are the plants which are from the group of angiosperms and from the gymnosperms. So these are some examples of phanerogames. So here we discuss the differences between cryptogames and phanerogames. Now we will discuss these phanerogames, means gymnosperms and angiosperms, in detail. So for this, let's start here with the gymnosperms. Now we will discuss about the gymnosperms. Up to now we discussed about the thallophyta, bralphyta and pteridophyta. All these are known as cryptogames. All these are known as cryptogames. Now we will discuss about the gymnosperms. The gymnosperms, word gymno means naked and the sperms means seed. So these are the plants which are the naked plants which bear the naked seeds. Abhi tak humne jo characteristics dekhi thi, that plant has a differentiated plant body. They have vascular tissues are present or not. Next is are they able to produce seed. Yahan tak ki sari characteristics in plants ke andar hai. They have differentiated plant body, they have vascular tissues, they are able to produce seed. But now they will divide it into, or we can say they are classified onto the basis whether the seeds are naked or they are present or enclosed inside the fruit. Ab is category ke basis pe hi further divide kiya gaya ki seed agar produce naked form mein produce ho rahe, then we call these plants as the gymnosperm, and if the seeds are present inside the fruit, then we call them angiosperms. So gymnosperms are the seed producing यूजिंग प्लांट्स बट सीड्स आर नेट सीड्स. मींस हम क्या करते हैं कि ये जो प्लांट्स हैं जिम्नोस्पर्म्स, इनके सीड हमें बाहर से दिखाई देते हैं. लाइक मैंगो हो गया, एप्पल हो गया, आप बाहर से नहीं देख सकते. दीज सीड्स आर प्रेजेंट इनसाइड द फ्रूट. बट इन जिम्नोस्पर्म्स के अंदर क्या होता है, बड़े बड़े सीड हैं एंड दे सीड आर डायरेक्टली वी कैन सी फ्रॉम द आउटसाइड. इफ यू एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट, अगर आप कभी किसी हिली एरिया पे गए हैं, हिली एरिया पे आपको कॉन लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स जो होती हैं दिखाई देती है, क्योंकि ये जो प्लांट्स हैं जिम्नोस्पर्म दे मेनली फाउंड एट द हिली एरियाज लाइक पाइंस हो गया. वहाँ पे इनके जो सीड्स हैं बड़े बड़े कॉन शेप के सीड जो है वो हमें वहाँ पे जगह जगह पे दिखाई देते हैं गिरे हुए, अगर आपने कभी देखे हो तो. दैट्स व्हाई वी आर सेइंग दैट दे आर दे प्रोड्यूस नेट सीड्स. इनके सीड जो होते हैं वो नेट सीड होते हैं. एंड द अनदर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ दीज आर दे आर पेरिनियल एवरग्रीन एंड वुडी. पेरिनियल मीन्स दे हैव द वेरी लॉन्ग लाइफ, कई सालों तक सर्वाइव करते हैं. एवरग्रीन रहते हैं, ग्रीन रहेंगे. दे डू नॉट मीन्स दे डू नॉट शेड देयर लीव्स. They remain evergreen and they have woody plants, means they have strong stem. Woody plants होंगे. Example of these plants are pines and cycas. These are the example of gymnosperms. So they are evergreen plants. ये कुछ important चीजें हैं जो हमने यहाँ पे discuss की हैं about the gymnosperms. Now we will discuss about the next group of the planting kingdom, that is angiosperms, in which also that they produce seeds, but the seeds remains inside the fruits. So let's start with the angiosperm now. Now let's discuss about the angiosperm. Angiosperms are the plants which have covered seeds. Means we are saying that these are the plants which form seeds, and seeds are present into the special reproductive structure which is known as fruit. Seeds जो होते हैं fruit के अंदर present होते हैं. They are covered seeds. That's the meaning of this name of angiosperm also. Angio means covered and sperm means seeds, means they have covered seeds. Like in the gymnosperm we have seen that seeds are nicked seeds, but in angiosperms the seeds are present inside the fruit. And these plants are also flowering plants, means they form the flower also. The flower is later on converted into the fruit. Flower hi aage jaake fir fruit mein convert hota hai, and inside the fruit the seed is formed. In which seed के अंदर क्या होता है, seed contain two structure, the one is the embryo. Seed contain the future plant. In embryo को हम कह सकते हैं that this is the future plant. Embryo जो होता है वो आगे जाके नया plant form करने का काम करते हैं, that's why it is known as future plant. And the cotyledon are known as seed leaf. इन्हें हम seed leaf बोलते हैं. They are the leaf-like structure which contain the nutrition for this growing embryo. So what are we are discussing? We are discussing about the seed. In the angiosperms, the seed is formed and the seed contains two important structures. First is the embryo and another one is the cotyledon. Embryo makes the future plant. Embryo se hi naya plant form hoga. And the cotyledon which are present around the embryo. So cotyledon embryo ke around present hota hai. They provide the food to the growing embryo. ये इस ग्रोइंग एम्ब्रियो को फूड प्रोवाइड करने का काम करते हैं. कंटेन द न्यूट्रिशन. जब तक ये एम्ब्रियो डेवलप होके, जैसे एम्ब्रियो फॉर्म होगा, एम्ब्रियो फॉर्म होने पे सबसे पहले नीचे की तरफ रेडिकल फॉर्म होता है, यानी कि रूट्स बनती हैं. देन इट स्टार्ट फॉर्मिंग द स्टेम एंड स्टेम पे लीफ आएंगी. जब तक रूट और लीफ अपना काम स्टार्ट नहीं कर देती है, तब तक इस ग्रोइंग एम्ब्रियो को जो न्यूट्रिशन मिलेगा वो मिलेगा इन कॉटिलिडन से, इन लीफ लाइक स्ट्रक्चर से जिसे हम बोलते हैं cotyledon. So these are the flowering plants. Seeds are covered inside the fruit and the seed contain embryo and cotyledon. Most of the plant which we see around us, they all are angiosperms. Mostly jitne bhi hum plant apne aas pass dekh rahe hain sab angiosperms hai, like apple, mango, jo bhi trees aapko nazar aa rahe, these are the plants which have fruit inside the seeds inside the fruit. Inke andar seed jo hai wo fruit ke andar present hai. Now these angiosperms are further divided into the two groups. Angiosperm को हम आगे फिर से divide कर रहे हैं on the basis of the number of cotyledons. Here we talked about the cotyledon. हमने cotyledon की बात कर ली है, जो कि leaf-like structure है, seed के अंदर present है. If the cotyledon is one, if one cotyledon is present, then we call these plant as monocot. तब इन plants को हम कहेंगे monocot plants. And if the two cotyledon present, then we call that dicotyledon, or in short we can call it dicot plants. So here we divided the angiosperms into the two further groups, monopod and dipod, on the basis of the cotyledon. If one cotyledon is present, then they are called as monopod, and if two cotyledons are present, then we call it dicot or dicotyledon. Now, these monopod and dipod can be further, means we can divide and differentiate these monopod and dipod. आपके आसपास जो बहुत सारे प्लांट हैं, इनमें से कुछ मोनोपोड होंगे, कुछ डाइकोट होंगे, लाइक राइस हो गया, पीच हो गया, मैंगो, बनाना. यू आर एबल टू सी मैनी प्लांट्स अराउंड यू. हाउ यू कैन डिफरेंशिएट बिटवीन मोनोपोड एंड डाइकोट, कैसे आप इन्हें डिफरेंशिएट कर सकते हैं? इनके लिए कुछ इनके स्पेशल डिफरेंसेस हैं. वी विल टॉक अबाउट द डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन मोनोपोड एंड डाइकोट. अगर मोनोपोड और डाइकोट के डिफरेंसेस की बात करते हैं, दे हैव सम पर्टिकुलर डिफरेंस. Here we are writing about the monopod, and here we are writing about the dipod. In the monopod plants, we are saying that they have one cotyledon. In the middle, one cotyledon here, and in dipod they have two cotyledon. Okay, this is the first difference. But ये चीज़ हम बाहर से देखें तो पता नहीं लगा सकते कि plant monopod है या dipod है. To identify this, we have to see the leaf. हम leaf को देख के identify कर सकते हैं that plant is a monopod plant or it's a dipod plant. If the plant has parallel venation, like आपने venations पढ़ा होगा अपनी पिछली क्लास के अंदर, अगर plants में leaf के अंदर venation parallel venation होता है, जिसमें veins एक दूसरे के parallel grow करती हैं, such type of plants which have parallel leaf venation, they are the monopod. उन्हें हम कौन से प्लांट्स बोलेंगे? मोनोपोड्स. मींस वी कैन से दैट इन द मोनोपोड प्लांट्स द लीव्स हैव पैरेलल वेरिएशन, वेयर एज इन द डाइपोड्स प्लांट्स लीव्स आर फॉर्मिंग अ नेक लाइक स्ट्रक्चर. मतलब एक नेक लाइक वेरिएशन फॉर्म होता है, एंड दिस वेरिएशन इज नोन एज रेटिकुलेट वेरिएशन. सो इन द मोनोपोड वी कैन से दे हैव पैरेलल वेरिएशन, दे हैव पैरेलल वेरिएशन, whereas in the dipod plants they have reticulate venation. इनमें जो leaf के अंदर veins present करती हैं, in the dipod plants the venation is the parallel venation, whereas in the dipod plants the venation is the reticulate venation. अगर talk about the roots also, in the monopod plants the roots are the fibrous root. Whereas in the dipod plants, the roots have the tap root system. Tap root. You know that in the fibrous root, the root which arises from the base of the stem, they make a group of the roots. इस तरीके से group एक जाल या एक गुच्छा बनता है, fibrous structure form होती है. इस तरीके की root को बोलते हैं fibrous root. इसमें कोई भी एक main root नहीं है. But whereas in the prime tap root system, one main root is formed. मेन रूट बनती है, एंड फ्रॉम दिस मेन रूट द अनदर रूट्स विल एमर्ज. बाकी जो रूट्स होती है वो इसी एक मेन रूट से एमर्ज होती है. दिस टाइप ऑफ रूट सिस्टम इज नोन एज टैप रूट सिस्टम. सो वी कैन आइडेंटिफाई द प्लांट्स ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ रूट्स एंड देयर लीफ फिनिश आल्सो. इन द मोनोपोड प्लांट्स द रूट्स आर द फाइब्रस रूट लाइक दिस, एंड इन द डाइपोड प्लांट्स द रूट्स आर टैप रूट लाइक दिस वे. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द वास्कुलर टिश्यूज आल्सो, in the case of monopod plants the vascular tissues like xylem and phloem they are present inside the stem. Stem ke andar vascular tissues hain jo ki transportation mein help kar rahe hain. They are complexly arranged, ye ek fixed way mein arrange nahi hote, jabki in the dipod plants these vascular tissues are arranged into a ring manner. Xylem phloem in segments mein ring mein arrange hote hain. So these are the some another differences also. So here we discuss about the angiosperms, and we know that angiosperms are divided further into the two groups, monopod and dipod, on the basis of number of cotyledons. We discuss the differences between monopod and dipod also. So here with this we completed our kingdom planting. Now in the next video we will discuss about the next kingdom, which is Animalia. Keep watching, keep studying, and keep learning.